In this tutorial, I'm going to explain metering modes such as evaluative or matrix metering, center weighted, spot, partial, and highlight weighted metering modes in DSLR cameras. I will also provide examples of images shot with these metering modes. But before I continue, I would like to remind you to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that you'll be notified when I upload new tutorials. And also, in the video description below, I provide time codes of the timeline of the video content. So, if there's a particular topic of the video that you want to watch, you can click on the specific time code. That way, you do not have to watch the entire video if you don't need to. I personally go over all closed captions for my tutorials. If you find it helpful, turn on the closed captions. Now back to the tutorial. Proper exposure in photography is extremely important. If the sensor or film is not properly exposed, the image becomes either under or overexposed, leading to dark or light images. To aid photographers with exposure, most cameras have a built-in light meter in them. You use a light meter to determine the light reading and make a proper exposure. The light meter reads the various tonalities of light within the frame and gives the reading to the light meter. Most modern day DSLR or mirrorless cameras have three or four types of metering modes integrated in them. Camera manufacturers use different names for these modes, but they generally are the same. Let's start with evaluative or matrix metering mode. Canon calls it evaluative and Nikon calls it matrix. Other manufacturers have their own nomenclature. Evaluative or matrix is the default metering mode, and this generally works well for most everyday situations. When Canon or Nikon cameras are set to automatic shooting mode, the metering mode is set to evaluative or matrix. The evaluative or matrix metering mode is the most sophisticated among the metering modes. The camera frame is divided into various zones. Each zone takes light reading of that particular area, and the camera analyzes the light readings to recommend the exposure. The camera uses an algorithm to average the light reading and takes into consideration light, dark, middle gray values present within the frame. The algorithm also takes into consideration the autofocus point being used, as it thinks the point is important for the photograph. Evaluative or matrix metering mode tries to consider situations such as backlight or off-center subject matter when analyzing light readings. In most circumstances, I use evaluative or matrix metering mode. Center-weighted metering mode places greater emphasis on the center while also taking meter readings across the entire frame. Center-weighted is good for photographs with subjects in the center of the frame. It may not work for subjects that are off-centered with varying brightness than the center. Spot metering, on the other hand, covers around 1 to 3% of the entire frame. The exact percentage of coverage depends upon the camera model. In modern day digital cameras, the spot can be co-located with an autofocus point. This mode is good for taking light meter readings of the specific point or an area in the frame. In instance such as taking a meter reading of an actor on a stage under a spotlight. Partial metering mode is available in Canon cameras. This mode works like spot metering, except it covers around 8% of the frame at the center. This particular camera, Nikon D810, also uses highlight weighted mode. It assigns greatest weight to highlights, reducing loss of detail in highlight areas due to overexposure. Now, let me show you some examples of photographs taken with these different modes. Here is my beautiful partner and wife Kausila. In the first set of examples, Kausila is being lit with evenly diffused window light. In situations where light is even, it does not make too much difference which mode you use. For this image, evaluative or matrix metering mode was used. In the second image, partial metering mode was used. Partial mode is integrated in the Canon cameras and they cover around 8% of the frame at the center. For the third image, spot metering mode was used. And for the fourth, center weighted. As you can see, there is not much difference between the four and the exposures are pretty good. Now let's look at different lighting situations. In this scenario, Kausala is sitting sideways to the window. The right side of the face is well lit, but the left side is partially in shadow. For this kind of lighting, it is important to know which metering mode to use. But first, let's take a look at photos taken with evaluative or matrix mode. Overall, the exposure is not bad, but there are certainly some shortcomings. In this mode, the camera takes information of shadow areas, highlights, and middle gray areas of the entire frame and provides an exposure reading. If you look at the edges on the right side of our face, you will see that the highlights are overexposed. There is a subtle difference in center weighted. In center weighted, Kausala's face is slightly brighter. The shadow areas are lighter and the highlights are even more overexposed. For the third image, spot metering mode was used. The area on her cheeks, just to the right of her nose, was used to take spot meter reading. In terms of overall tonalities, this image is the best among the three. There are a lot of middle gray areas on her face with some shadow areas that are not too dark and highlight areas that are not blown out. Now let's take a look at one more set of examples. In this example, Kausala is outside standing in a shaded area and the background is brightly lit with the morning sun. For the first image, evaluative or matrix mode was used. Since there is so much difference between the bright and dark areas, it did not really do a good job. Kausala's face is underexposed. Partial metering mode integrated in Canon cameras did a better job. Her face is less underexposed. The third image used spot metering. This is the best so far in terms of exposure, although I screwed up with the focusing. Since the light reading was based on Kausala's face, her face is properly exposed. The fourth one is with center weighted. In this mode, it gives emphasis to the center, but also takes into account light readings outside of the center. Hence, the face is underexposed in this mode. As you can see, you have to take into account the overall lighting scenario when choosing a metering mode. It is extremely important you understand each metering mode and use them for appropriate situations, as light readings and its interpretation is key in photography. That wraps up my metering mode tutorial. Please use the comment section below if you have any questions or comments. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon to be notified when I upload new tutorials.